Good morning to you all students. Myself, Dr. Meenu Goyal from Sri Aurobindo College of Commerce and Management, Ludhiana. I'm going to share with you the topic Transportation Problems in OR. Now, in this case, transportation is one of the type of LPP, that is linear programming problem. The objective of transportation is to move a single commodity, homogeneous commodity, I would say, to different destinations in such a way that the total transportation cost is minimum. So the basic objective of transportation problems is to minimize the transportation cost. The terminology used in the chapter or in the transportation models is first the feasible solution. When we are talking about the feasible solution, we are talking about the constraints of supply and demand. Here demand should be equal to supply. Then the basic feasible solution, if the number of positive allocations are m plus n minus 1, it implies the number of rows plus columns minus 1. Okay. Then the third one is the optimal solution. A feasible solution is said to be optimal if it minimizes the total transportation cost. The feasible solution used to only satisfy the demand and supply constraint, and the optimal solution is going to provide you with the minimum solution, the minimum transportation cost. Next is the balanced transportation problem, where demand is equal to supply. That problem is said to be the balanced problem, and if the demand is not equal to supply, the problem is unbalanced. Now in this case, to make the unbalanced problem balance, we need to add the dummy row or column whichever is less as per the demand and supply constraints. Next comes the degeneracy concept in transportation. If the number of allocations attained is not equal to m plus n minus 1, in that case we say the problem is said to be degenerate. Further, it would be elaborated in further videos how this degeneracy can be resolved. When we want to solve these transportation problems, first of all we need to make a matrix, then we have to gain the initial basic feasible solution, and the third one is to attain the optimal solution. The initial basic feasible solution, or IBFS. To calculate IBFS, we are having three methods: Northwest Corner method and WCM, the lowest cost entry method LCEM, or also known as matrix minima method, and the third one, Vogel's approximation method or VAM method. Out of these three methods, this gives the best results, that is the lowest cost. As per the application of these methods, you have to apply the method as per the question which is being asked, and otherwise you can apply the Vogel's method because it is going to give you the minimum solution, minimum cost. And the methods for optimal solution are stepping stone method or modified distribution method, also known as Modi method. Next comes the assumptions of this transportation model. When we are talking about the basic assumptions, we are talking about the availability of the quantity. The quantity is equal. Okay. The total requirements as well as the total requirements from the different sources. Okay. That should be equal to the total demand. Then is the transportation of items. Every production center can send the goods or move the goods or transfer the goods to every consumption center. Then the cost per unit of all the items, that is certain. It is already given in the matrix. That would be very much clear when we are discussing the matrix in the next video. The cost we are talking about is independent of the quantity dispatched. That is the basically LPP. Per unit cost remains the same. It hardly matters you are moving one unit or you are moving 100 units. The cost per unit cost remains the same. And the objective is to minimize the total transportation cost. I would be catching you in the next video. हैप्पी लर्निंग।